Hey there, Warriors. Mr. Chmiel here, just spending a day in the office and thinking about you guys. This is a message for the class of 2020. I wanted to give you guys an update in terms of what we're doing for graduation. So you probably heard that on May 28th, Governor Murphy, in his remarks, said that schools could begin to hold in-person graduation ceremonies starting on July 6th. Assuming that they follow physical distancing guidelines. So as soon as we heard about that, as an administrative team, we began to plan for it. And we think that we created a really solid plan that will honor you as a class and also comply with state and local guidelines for safety. So there'll be a lot of information about that in my letter that's going to be on the Franklin High School webpage, but I wanted to give you a little bit of an overview. So a certain number of you would come for each ceremony. Part of the guidelines from Governor Murphy is that if you have a large school, you have to have multiple ceremonies. So we're going to divide it up into multiple ceremonies, but you would come with two family members only. We have to respect our guidelines with that. We can't be too crowded in Warrior Stadium. But you would come with your two family members in cap and gown, park in a designated parking spot, and line up to go into Warrior Stadium. And then you would meet the classmates who you'd be graduating with and march in with pomp and circumstance, which is very cool. And you'd take your place and see the presentation of the colors by the Franklin High School JROTC, as well as the singing of the national anthem. There would also be a couple short speeches, and then it would be time to call you up for your diploma. And we feel that the alignment that we have in terms of where your family members will be seated, they're going to get a much better view of you as a group than they would under normal circumstances when it's really big graduation, over 500 people. So they'll be able to see you head on, which is very cool, and they'll take a picture of you right as you go across and receive your diploma. And we'll have a professional photographer there to take a high-quality picture right there on the field. And then we'll have the turning of our tassels, which symbolizes graduation, and we would march out with a recessional. So we're having this in addition to a video graduation celebration that's still being prepared for you with the speeches from your valedictorian, your salutatorian, class president, a short speech from me, the spoken word by Queen of Bergen, which it was filmed with 360-degree camera, so you'll feel like you're there in virtual reality. My speech is that way, too. It's going to look really, really cool. We're going to be having video shout-outs from your teachers that go into the presentation, possibly some shout-outs from you guys to each other, and all of that is going to be wrapped together and prepared for you to view on June 23rd. Which is the last day of school. And then after our in-person ceremonies during the week of July 13th, there'll be multiple sessions each day. We're going to take video footage of the in-person ceremonies, put that together with everything that was there on the 23rd, and you'll get one gigantic graduation memento and keepsake. So we hope that you could see these things that we're trying to do, and you know, we can't give you back the prom, the yearbook signing dinner, project graduation, which, believe me, we miss that too. I mean, that's a lot of fun for us as administrators and faculty and staff. But some of the stuff was beyond our control, as you know, and if we could give something back to you, such as an in-person ceremony, then we're going to do our best to do it and to make you guys happy. So until next time, don't forget to check out my letter on the Franklin High School webpage, and take care.